Assalamualaikum. Hello, 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 and welcome to my YouTube channel. I just want to talk with you guys today. I just want to sit down and talk. No script, nothing. I just want to let out something that's been on my mind for a while. I wrote about it in my book, The Other Side of the Coin, which it's here. Wait. You know. And by the way, I'm a bit under the weather, so if I sound a little bit like birds, it's because of that. So in this book, I wrote about it. I wrote about this like 4, maybe 5 years ago. I don't remember by now, but it's still a problem for me because I think the mindset is still there. The reason why I wrote about it is because I want to create some sort of change. But the changes are happening. It's just that I don't know. Maybe it's just a selfish version of me wanting a change to happen quicker than it is right now. What is this problem? Oh my god, so mysterious. It's a big problem for me. It might not be a big problem for you, but you know, since you know we're just talking, so why not? People, they have this tendency. And when I say people, I don't mean all people, but some people, they have this tendency to make a conclusion that somebody is an ustaz or an ustaza. If that term is alien to you, that means a religious teacher, somebody who teaches Islam, ustaz, ustaza. In Canada, where I studied for 4 years, that term means just that, a teacher who teaches Islam. And you don't just call somebody that without, you know, that person having proper qualification. So you only call somebody an ustaz when somebody has proper qualification. But in Malaysia, it's a bit different because culturally we use that term rather loosely. So if you see somebody who looks religious, who maybe talks religiously, so you call them ustaz or ustaza. Now this might seem harmless on the surface, but when this labeling persists, it turns into this whole mindset that if somebody looks religious, talks religiously, that means that person must be an ustaz. And it happens to me because I happen to talk a lot about my faith, my religion, whenever I talk about topics that I care about, like youth topics, like love, community, relationship, even sometimes politics, spiritual issues, emotional issues, psychological issues. I like to relate back to my faith because my faith is a part of who I am, and this medium that I'm using is me opening up and expressing parts of myself, my opinions and thoughts. So my faith will naturally come out in these kind of situations. It's not something that I want to exclude because it is part of myself. But when I express my views and opinions and I use my understanding of Islam together with it, people sort of assume that, oh, this guy must know a lot about Islam. And then they proceed to calling me like ustaz and so on and so forth. So they continue asking me like all these complicated religious questions, like fiqh related questions. Fiqh, by the way, means like legal questions. Like, is this permissible or is it not? Let me be clear, I am not in any way, shape or form an ustaz, even though you might look at me and see me as somebody who might be an ustaz because, you know, I have this beard and sometimes I wear like a skull cap or a kopiah, as we call it, or sometimes I wear a jubah. All those things are all, and I'm using these words very carefully, superficial, on the surface, only the skin. It doesn't define like my knowledge level or my how deep I understand Islam. And don't get me wrong, I am not trying to be ungrateful. I am thankful and grateful that people are thinking well of me. But at the same time, I realize that if I don't address this, then people might assume that I am the person who is qualified to be in the position of answering all these questions that clearly I am not capable of doing. So I just want to make it clear. I am grateful, yes, But I know my place. I know where I am. I know when I'm in somebody else's zone. So that's it. That's basically what I want to talk about. I'm not an ustaz. So I just want to address this concern of mine, because people look at somebody on the outside and they make a conclusion, oh, this person might be a good person. This person looks like somebody who could be an imam, could lead the prayer. All these outer things like the beard and the kopiah and the jubah and everything, you can easily have them. Easily. This beard, I did nothing. I just let them grow. The jubah, I bought it. The kopiah, I bought it too. All those things are cheaply available, and if we use these symbols as an easy conclusion of how deeply somebody's knowledge is, then that could lead to a problem, because we then associate a noble profession, I could say, ustaz, being a teacher of Islam, a noble profession, to somebody who is not qualified, for example, me. So I just want to make that clear. Again, it might not be a big of an issue, but for me it is, because I have this huge respect for the knowledge, I have this huge respect for the science, the deen, that I don't want it to be misassociated with somebody who's not qualified to be its voice, like myself. But I still include it in my thoughts and views, because that's who I am. So I'm doing all this as a Muslim, not as a scholar or an ustaz. But again, I appreciate the good thoughts that people have of me. So I don't want this video to come off as me being rude or anything like that. It's just me being respectful. That's the word. Respectful of the knowledge, Islam, the deen, and respectful of the people who look at me so that they don't misunderstand my position. I'm very transparent. I don't hide anything. You go on my website, you know my background, my academic background, the kind of talks that I give. It's all there. I don't hide anything. I am from a science background. My degree is in biology and psychology. Right now I'm doing a master's degree in counseling. That's my field, and I know my place. That's my place. So I want to make the best of myself and bring the most impact to the community in that field. So that's that. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe, like, share, comment, and again, don't misunderstand. I'm grateful, but I just want to be respectful to the whole knowledge, and I don't want people to misunderstand my position and where I stand. I know my place, and I hope that people know my place as well. Yeah, that's it. Thank you. Assalamualaikum. Bye-bye.